Here we are inside of Snapseed's Tune Image Tools menu. What you are seeing right now is my original image. This is the unaltered photo straight off my phone. It's a nice composition, but to be critical, the photo that my phone captures feels flat and hazy. This one feels low in saturation and punch, so let's tune it up. Now, if this is the first time that you've ever entered this part of the program, then Snapseed might try to show you a quick demonstration of how their tool's interface works. But in case you missed it, and because I have some tricks that their demo doesn't mention, let me explain some of the hidden secrets in here. As you slide your finger up or down, a menu will magically appear. Slide your finger up or down until the blue highlight is over the feature that you want to use. For this image, I'm going to start with the Shadows menu. Once you release your finger, you should see the name of the control that you have chosen down there at the bottom of the screen. Now, swipe your finger from right to left or left to right to set a new value for this control. With the Shadows control, for example, moving my finger to the left sets a negative value, which makes the darker parts of this image, like the shadows under those plants around the pond, much darker. Swiping my finger to the right will raise the shadow value and make those areas of this image brighter. If you end up setting a value, like I have here, that is not really improving your image, then you can either slide your finger the other way across the screen again until you reach a better value, or you can double tap on the name of the control down there on the toolbar at the bottom of the screen. If I double tap, if I tap twice really quickly on the word shadows down there on the toolbar, then Snapseed will automatically reset this control for me. That was easy, and it's not just the shadows control. Anytime you want to reset any tool back to its initial settings, just double tap on its name down there at the bottom. At this point, I need to explain that there are no absolutes in photography. I'm going to demonstrate how I use the tools in this Tune Image group to improve this image, but I need to make it clear that the numbers that I choose in here do not mean anything on their own. See, each photo is a unique puzzle. The numbers that look great on this image might look terrible on another photo. What I hope you will learn here is that every photo could use a little tuning up, but we will only discover the right formula, the right, quote, numbers, for styling that particular image by experimenting. For landscape photos like this one, I'm going to start by setting the shadows to about negative 50 or so, so that there's a strong black in the darkest parts of this image. A shadow value like that will make those green leaves and plants really separate from the darker spaces underneath them. Next, I'm going to swipe up on the main screen to bring out the hidden Tune Image Tools menu again. I'm going to slide up until the blue indicator rests on the highlights control. For this image, I want to bring the highlights all the way down, so I'll swipe my finger to the left to put more detail into those bright flowers over there in the center right of the screen. Let me double tap on that area to zoom in so you can see what a difference this control really makes. Brighter, darker. I'm going to double tap again to zoom back out. Next, I will swipe my finger up again to choose a new tool. This time, I'm going to go all the way up to the brightness control. The shadows and highlights are targeted tools. The brightness control, on the other hand, can make the whole image lighter or darker. In this case, I'm going to choose a brightness of about plus 20 to make the whole scene feel just a little lighter. Next, I'm going to swipe up again to reveal the tool image menu, and I'm going to come down to the ambience control. Now, ambience is one of my favorite features in the entire program. Google says that the ambience control is a special type of contrast filter that adjusts the balance of light in a photo. It can be used to balance out backlit photos or to accentuate the color contrast throughout your image. What I find is that adding more ambience really adds a nice punch to my landscape and travel photos, With portraits, on the other hand, I will often use a negative ambience value to smooth out the light and to make someone's skin or their face look less contrasty. But what a difference adding some ambience will make on this photo. Now this photo is starting to come alive for me. Let's add two more refinements in here now. First, I'm going to bring out the tools menu again and scroll all the way down to the warmth control. Warmth is like white balance for those of us who are familiar with the controls that we have on a DSLR camera or the controls that we might have in an advanced camera app on our smartphone. Adding warmth will make our image more yellow. Setting a negative value here will add more blue light, which our eyes will perceive as cooler or colder. I'm going to add just a tiny bit of warmth in here to bump up that sunlit afternoon, late day, golden light feel. Finally, I'm going to go back into the Tune Image menu one last time, and I'm going to slide over to the saturation control. Saturation is defined as the strength of color. If you add saturation to a photo, then your colors will appear richer, all the way up to, say, nuclear crazy green, or yellow, or red. If you decrease the level of saturation, then your colors will appear to be more muted. Think of this as the difference between a soft pastel red and a fire engine neon red. Pulling the saturation control all the way down to negative 100, by the way, will give you a black and white image. We'll talk at length about other ways to make black and whites with Snapseed later. But for now, sliding this control all the way down is a great way to see what the saturation slider does. I'm going to double tap here just to reset the saturation. On this image, I feel like just a little more saturation, a value of about plus 20 or so, is all that it takes to really make those beautiful flowers pop. Okay, now I'm happy. But to get a sense of what we have accomplished here, I think we need to compare what you see on the screen at this point with my original cell phone shot. To see a before and after, press and hold your finger on this button up here in the top right corner. Before, after. Before, after. Wow, what a difference these tools have made. We've gone from an okay composition, but a flat, hazy capture, to something that really leaps off the screen and commands the viewer's attention. Again, I want to emphasize that the numbers that I have chosen for this image don't mean anything, but there's a pattern that you can learn here. When you're working on landscape or travel images, our eyes generally love to see photos with strong dark shadows, lots of color, a bit of ambience, and a touch of saturation. We'll talk about how I tune up other types of images elsewhere, but we're not quite done with this tutorial yet. So let's say that you're thrilled with our image at this point. To commit the changes that we have made so far, we need to tap on that little check mark down there in the lower right-hand corner. If, on the other hand, you feel like you made an awful mess and you want to undo everything that we have done with all the tools in this area, then all you have to do is tap on the little X button at the bottom left side of the screen. Tapping the X button will back you out of the Tune Image menu without making any changes. But I'm delighted with how things have turned out here, so I'm going to click on the check mark to set those changes and to return to Snapseed's main screen. Let me show you one more feature here before I end this lesson. If you press and hold one finger against your image at this point, back here on the main screen, then you can toggle that before and after view on and off again. While your finger is pressed against the screen, you can see your original image. And when you let go, you will see what you have created up to this point using any or all of the tools in Snapseed. If you really love your results right now, then go ahead and click on the Save button up there at the top of the screen. If you've enjoyed this lesson, move on to the next tutorial, because there's lots more that we can do to improve our photos here in Snapseed.